it was extreme. I had waves of 20 meters, and wow. I had winds of up to about 80 knots, which is like 125 miles an hour.
That's...
And the rudder got damaged in the back. The transom, which is the stern of the boat, the back of the boat, that got damaged and started taking water. And I had to do a bit of pocket brigade in local terminology, fishing pocket brigade to be able to keep her afloat. And after that, it was too late. It was the last window I had in terms of the opportunity because it was already the storming time here on this side.
Okay.
So I was returning back to wait for a better weather to sail to the USA here.
Okay. Well, it's such a touching story, actually. I didn't even realize how much damage had been taken and what you had to endure to make it back here. So that
is actually... Not to make it back here, I flew over here because this was one of my points of sale. You know, the boat is back at the Azores, waiting me to return back there to continue sailing. And I'm going to be sailing in May. I go back on the 15th of May. I'm going to be going back to the Azores. And I'm going to be sailing to the UK here in June. Sometime in June, that's when we're going to have better weather. So now the boat's going to be leaving the Caribbean to come back up to the north.
Understood.
And so I'll be sailing back to the UK here, and this is where I'm going to be outfitting the boat for everything, because I need to get a new sail and install an engine, proper electronic equipment, navigational equipment, life raft, the signal flares for emergencies, EPIRB, emergency beacon system. That is, to break it down more simple, that is a unit that when you put it on, it sends out a signal direct to any commercial vessel, any cargo ship, any airplane, any military ship also, direct, and they get that signal and they locate you, you exactly where you are. It's a GPS position system also. So I'll get those, and then proper, which is one of the key things with the story matters in that event, is to have the proper equipment to be able to record the journey, so then the story can be told and can be seen, and to be able to educate as it is all meant.
Yes, and I can imagine that's not a cheap process to re-kit the boat and install the items. Is there any way at the moment where you can get support through that? Anyone willing to support you? Do you have like a GoFundMe page that people can make a donation, as it were, for these?
First of all, I'm going to say an adventure like that, a mission like that, is very expensive. First of all, when you talk about the sea, you talk about money.
Yeah.
And to outfit that, you look at an approximation of £50,000. In US dollars, you edit that in an approximation of about 60, 70, somewhere around there, in that area. And to get it going, then to support the trip as well, then you're talking about, you can't really put a figure on it, because there's always the event that is happening, that you would have to pull in the port, maybe make emergency repairs or major repairs, it all depends. So you're talking about that would be an extra amount, you know, figure that to be able to support that, and you're looking anywhere around like 40,000. Yeah, so with that, I'm going to be having a Indiegogo campaign. Is not quite ready yet, but very soon, very shortly, and the information will be passed out.
Yes,
whenever it's ready. Yes, that's going to be up early next week, that's willing, Indiegogo, that's a platform. And that is where people are going to be able to donate. They'll be able to see and follow on Twitter, on Facebook, on YouTube, the development on how it's going. And while saying that, also on the journey, there's a system called AIS system, which can be directly linked to the people back online, satellite linked, so then people can follow, like you have the Vandenberg, Yeah, that system will be in place.
Okay.
So then people can track you and they can have a live connection, this sort of thing, yeah.
Fabulous.
Yeah, so that is one part of it. Connection in terms of to get information and stuff like that, I got my Facebook page.
Yes, please.
That's Joel Mark on Facebook. There was a GoFundMe that was used when I needed support in the Azores after I turned back to come to the UK here. And that's also on Facebook. It's Joel Mark Solo Circuit Navigation. Then I have a UK number here, which is 077-5177-0990.
Can you just repeat that again, just in case? Get your pens and paper out. It was very perfectly, but just the warning there, so we're about to read the number out one more time.
You never heard to repeat that.
Never.
It's 077-5177-0990. Yeah, that's one of the contacts. Then I have one of my cousins here. That's Abeni, A-B-E-N-I, Alexander. It's 07-9465-88860. And that's another contact. That's the person who's going to be running the Indiegogo campaign, going to be managing it. Yeah. And then they have Ms. Swindadabo with the D-A-R-B-E-A-U. That's French, yeah? He's got a place in Greta called Dabo. And that number is 07-399-728185. Should I repeat that?
Yeah, you can do it.
Ms. Swindadabo, 07-399-728185. That's Ms. Swindadabo. Then I got my email address. My email address is officialcaptainjex@gmail.com. And the Jex is J-E-X. J-E-X. Officialcaptainjex@gmail.com. Those are contacts. Then you also have, as most people here would know, but those who wouldn't know, is the Grenada High Commission. It's 0208-8318-3882. It's the Grenada High Commission. And the email is office of Grenada High Commission.co.uk. So if you get in touch with these people, then you will get in touch with me. Something I would like to mention again is that one of the things that people will be teaching, I want to highlight that is because we'll be learning, fishing is a big industry in Grenada, and there is a need for it to be taught at school level, that was like a curriculum. And also I'll be working with the schools in Grenada to make it as a curriculum activity in the schools.
That's really good. That's, again, helping use the natural resources
exactly.
The island. That's,
we're surrounded by water.
This is it.
I think everyone deserves the right to have the opportunity to be able to do something with the water, whether they want to swim, learn to fish, learn to sail, something of the sort,
That's very powerful.
It is. And I feel good about it, not that, being, what should I say, in the spotlight, but it's all about, doing something. Because when I think about the end of it, I always see, me teaching, because I was always instrumental and I always love teaching people and handing my knowledge down. It's very important.
Excuse me. Sorry, I do apologize.
That's right.
No, it's something I always believe in as well, so it's got, it's so powerful to see it in action. It's something that always warms me. Just going back to your email address, and it was a question I was going to ask, the name Captain Jex, where did that come from?
Well, I'm also a professional online fishing boat captain. That's fishing for swordfish and tuna.
Okay.
Swordfish has got a sword like a Zorro. Yeah. And tuna. Yeah. And Jex, a lot of people know me in the fishing and, well, who here Jex, but Jex is my middle name. They didn't have a lot of people never knew it. They thought it was a nickname. But then they call me Captain, or Captain, and they call me Captain Jex. Make it
short. Okay, interesting. Okay, so there you go. Now you know, it didn't come out of nowhere. It's actually the Captain Jets' middle name became the first name. No, very great stuff. Okay, so no, thank you very much. It's been an honour to have met you. Even more inspiring to hear the story directly. And, well, the best of luck getting back to your boat and coming back down to the UK in June and to continue travelling the world on such a fantastic mission. And beyond that mission, empowering the youth and the people of Grenada the way that you have. Congratulations, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I hope to that I can inspire a lot of the people here.
Most definitely. I'm sure that is okay. What I'm going to do now, if you're okay with it, I'm just going to take the mic and see if anyone has any questions that they would like to ask you.
May I ask for the opportunity to thank a few other people here?
Please feel free.
I would like to thank Ms. Selena Dabo, who's been very instrumental. I met her in my first encounter here.
Just now?
She's active in seeking to raise funds. She's embarked on printing t-shirts and some caps to raise funds and bag, and she's going to be going. And also a pen. She made a pen on my birthday anyway. Yeah. Last year I was in Cuba for my birthday, and this year I didn't know where I was going to spend it, and I would say it's a pleasure.